Welcome to MT. Hope you enjoy the video.
Jeremiah arrives on the scene when the clay is on the wheel. God does not allow him to see the back parts, the hidden parts, the private parts, the broken parts, the messy parts. You see, if you're gonna be a potter, you can't be afraid to get your hands dirty. This is a messy business. Redemption is a messy business. Everybody who's called, thinks they're called to preach, is not ready to preach. Redemption is a messy business. And you have to be ready to get your hands dirty. We are introduced to both the potter and the clay on the wheel. When Jeremiah starts writing, he says the work that he wrought on the wheel. In other words, Jeremiah starts watching in the spin cycle. The clay is in the spin cycle. Now I want to digress a moment. I was talking to one of our pastors and I was telling him all through 2019 I was preaching about it feels like we're racing towards something and I didn't know what it was. I told my wife, it feels like I'm racing towards something and I don't know what it is. Everything keeps getting faster and faster in the world and it feels like we're headed for something. I could feel it all through 2019. I didn't know what it was, but I knew we were headed towards something. In 2020, we hit it. We step into the scene in the spin cycle. Point two, the potter's wheel is the spin cycle. When God gets ready to make something out of you, he puts you in the spin cycle. He puts you in the spin cycle where everything is a blur in the spin cycle. I've been pastoring this church soon to be 25 years, and when I look back at it, it's almost a blur. It doesn't feel like 25 years. Everything was happening so fast, I can't even describe everything about it. I'm still trying to dissect it because I was in the spin cycle. Some of you don't understand what you've been going through, but you've been in the spin cycle. Your life has been in a blur, but you've been in the spin cycle. You don't rest as good as you'd like to rest because you've been in the spin cycle. You don't know what to say about how you feel because you've been in the spin cycle. People ask you how you doing, you give them some candy apple answer because you haven't even diagnosed how you doing because everything's going around so fast, so fast, so fast, and all you know is that you're in the spin cycle. Can I talk to somebody in this place who's been in the spin cycle? All hell is breaking loose. Good things are happening there. Bad things are happening there. Sometimes you feel up and sometimes you feel down and sometimes everything's going so fast you can't even describe it or explain it or fully see it because you're in the spin cycle. But the Lord told me to tell you, he controls the speed of the spin.
I sat down a few years ago and I asked myself, okay, how do I add value to people? And I came up with three things that I want to pass on to you quickly. I add value to people, number one, when I value people. You got to value people, friend. You got to really love people. Don't be like Charlie Brown one time who said, you know, I love mankind, it's people I can't stand. You got to value people. You see, if I don't value you, I'll take advantage of you. Leaders who get in trouble because they stopped valuing the people that they lead. So I've got to value people. Number two, I have to know and relate to what you value. I have to know and relate to what you value, and I can only do that by listening. I can only do that by instead of talking and casting vision, turning to you and finding out where you are and how you feel, listening. Oh my goodness, the great leaders, they listen, they learn, and then they lead. They listen, they learn, and 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 they lead. If I want to add value to you, I have to value you. I have to know and relate to what you value. And number three, I have to make myself more valuable. If I'm really going to add value to you, guess what I have to do? I have to keep getting better, don't I? Because if I don't keep growing and if I don't keep getting better, it's impossible for you to keep growing and it's impossible for you to get better. And you see, in this business, You got to keep learning. You got to keep growing. I watch people in this type of work and they get to a level and they just kind of plateau and they get satisfied and they stop growing and they just kind of live off the level they're on and live off the land. Listen, the only way that you can be valuable to somebody tomorrow is learn something new today. When's the last time you learned something for the first time? This whole process of learning and growing and developing. But every day, add value, people.
Contextualize that you're early. I think a lot of people, when they think midlife, don't realize how early that is, and they feel this pressure that they need this to work. Once you take the pressure out that you might make this switch and it might not work, which you can then go back to the old thing or try a third thing, if you could eliminate that pressure, because it's about calibrating time. If you have a good relationship with time and realize, at how old is he? If you can just, was it Adam? I'm sorry, I didn't.
Yeah, Adam, how old are you? Post it in the comments.
You know, I wanna see it for context, and maybe it's not even for him. Maybe, Adam, if it's not for you, yeah. If it's for your mom or dad or somebody else, put the number of that age.
41.
Yeah, and Adam, is it for you? You can just say yes or what have you. You know, like, you know, to me, if it's for Adam, let's say, at 41 years old, he's uncomfortably young. Mm. Like, there's a really good chance on a conservative day, he's got 25 years of profession in front of him, which is more time than he's already put in since he was 18 to 22. Think about that. But that's not what we do, my friend. We don't do that. We do not do a good job in having a relationship with time. We think at 41 we're old because society has done a very bad job of creating time, because we're going off of old norms where people did live to 50 or 60, but we're living to 80, 90, and 100. And because of our health and wellness initiatives as a global society, we at 41, and mentally the youthification of our society, all of a sudden 41 is really 25, but nobody feels that. And so, you know, that's my biggest advice, which is take the pressure out. You know, when I see Amber at 34 in here, like, fuck, man, I look at 34 and I'm like, ugh. By the way, I restarted my life at 34. At 34, I had spent my entire life, 12 years, building a business for my dad. In a family business, I didn't get paid what I was worth. I built a business from 3 to 65 million. I was never making any real money at all because it was a family business. You know, you inherit it when your dad dies. I leave at 34, I own nothing. I don't own the wine library. I have no money on paper to get to borrow it even, but I fucking built it. So I've had this huge 12-year accomplishment, and what I get for it is to start over with zero, and I'm thrilled because I accomplished what I wanted, which is I wanted to do something great for my parents. Wow. That took humility and patience. I'm at 34, I start VaynerMedia in the conference room of Buddy Media because I don't have any money for us to pay rent.
God knows how to do a quick work. Quit believing those lies that it's gonna take you a long time to recover. You heard the experts. A long time to accomplish your dream. A long time to get free from that anxiety. No, God is crossing ahead of you right now so you can quickly conquer. You're going to see a rapid recovery. You're going to defy the odds. God is going to accelerate things. Dreams coming to pass in record time. Things falling into place. That depression is not permanent. That addiction is not going to last. It's about to hurry out of your way. It's going to happen quickly. You didn't see it coming. Now, when thoughts tell you, it's going to take you years to get well, years to meet the right person, no, keep this phrase down in your spirit, quickly conquer. You have to answer the doubt back with faith. Don't let that thought continue to play. It's permanent. It's never going to work out. No, all through the day, Father, thank you that it's going to happen quickly. Thank you that enemies are hurrying out of my way. Thank you that I'm going to see a rapid recovery. Well, Joel, what if I do that for a month and nothing happens? Keep doing it. You have to stay on the offensive. If you live with that lie that it's permanent, it's never going to change, that will limit your life. Luke chapter 18, Jesus told a story about a judge that wasn't fair. He didn't have integrity. He didn't care for people. This widow kept coming to him day after day, trying to get him to do something about a person that had done her wrong. The judge ignored her, didn't pay her any attention, but the widow wouldn't quit coming. Finally, the judge said to the lady, "I'm going to give you what you're asking for, not because I want to, but because you're wearing me out with your constant request." Jesus said to the disciples, if this judge who is not fair will make the right decision because the lady wouldn't quit asking, Do you think God, who is fair, will keep putting off those that come to him? Jesus went on to say, I can assure you, God will grant them justice quickly. When you're in a difficult time, things are not turning around. If you'll just keep thanking God that he's working, thanking him that he's fighting your battles, not begging him, but reminding him what he promised. Notice what God said. He will give you justice quickly. It's going to happen faster than you thought. One translation says, he will rush to your defense. He will come to you in haste. It may not have happened yet, but you need to know God is in a hurry to help you. You're going to see some of these sudden turnarounds. Now the key is to keep thanking him. Keep talking like it's going to happen. Keep believing that it's on the way. When you don't talk yourself out of it, you don't get discouraged, but you consistently thank God, you're going to see some of these quick works. He's going to quickly turn your child around, quickly bring your healing, quickly cause that dream to come to pass. Now maybe like this widow, you've been doing this, but you don't see anything changing. Everything looks the same. Stay encouraged. Your time is coming. God is crossing over ahead of you right now. I believe and declare you're about to quickly conquer. Problems that have held you back are about to suddenly resolve. Enemies that have hindered you are about to hurry out of your way. You're going to see a rapid recovery, a sudden breakthrough, a speedy turnaround. It's going to happen quickly.
Thank you for watching our video. Check out our other motivational videos that will help you turn your life in positive directions.